The Philippine government mulling its next steps after International Criminal Court prosecutor Kareem Khan renewed his call to investigate the Duterte administration's bloody drug war. Solicitor General Menardo Guevara says his office is assessing whether there's a need to reply to Khan's pronouncements. He adds the Philippine government will exhaust all legal remedies, including hiring foreign lawyers, regardless of the ICC pretrial chamber's ruling. But for Justice Secretary Boying Remulla, there's no need to respond to the ICC prosecutor.
We are not members of the ICC. We are doing this out of the principle of comity. Again, I tell you, we are being courteous to them. We do everything at our own pace in our own country. This is our country, not their country. Not Khan's country, not the prosecutor's country. If they want to put our people in jail, there has to be a reason for it and there has to be due process first.
Senator Ronald De La Rosa, who is considered the chief architect and implementer of the controversial drug war, also echoing Remulla's line.
Ano siya? Hello? Bakit siya mag-insist? Di ba? Kayo mismo, tanongin ko, you are witness to what is happening in this country. Meron ba tayong crimes against humanity na nangyayari dito? Wala naman. He is not a part of the Philippine government. He is not a part of the Philippine jurisdiction. And bakit siya nag-insist na makialam sa ating problema dito?
As the Philippine peso continues its slide against the U.S. dollar, importers are taking losses, preferring to act as a buffer between the greenback's strength and their customers. More from Juan de Guzman.
Ralph Ariño has had to take some losses on deals selling imported lights just to keep his customers happy and shielded from the effects of the strong U.S. dollar and the sliding Philippine peso. But he is hoping the peso doesn't weaken any further.
Malamang sa malamang, may mga projects kami na hindi na namin i-grab, no? Yung opportunity. So may mga bibitawan talaga na projects. And at the same, pero yung operation naman, hindi naman mawawala. Tuloy-tuloy pa rin. Kung sa industry namin, nakaka-survive pa rin, mas marami sigurong industry ang hindi na talaga kakayanin even at this point. Yung sa current na dollar value, no? So I hope na hindi na umangat pa.
While some sectors are hurting because of the dollar's strength, others should be benefiting, like the IT BPO sector, which earns in dollars. The industry estimates 70% of its business emanates from North America. Aside from the income, Filipino BPOs should be able to attract more customers because the weaker peso makes their services more affordable to dollar earners. But the IT and Business Process Association of the Philippines, or IBPAP, says because the dollar is strengthening against most other currencies, it's a wash.
It's a volatile situation, and we've seen the recent strength of the U.S. dollar affect other currencies as well. And many of those currencies are also the currencies of other emergent IT-BPM locations.
The peso closed near Tuesday's record low against the U.S. dollar in Wednesday trade. Some are saying an exchange rate of 65 is not out of the question. And many, including the IMF and World Bank, expect the dollar to continue to strengthen against global currencies. The World Bank notes the dollar's strength has had varying effects on different currencies, and the Philippine peso has remained somewhat resilient against other currencies in the region, alongside other major ASEAN economies. In fact, the World Bank sees the Philippines as one of the bright spots in the region thanks to a combination of relatively low inflation and high growth. IBPAP expects to contribute to that growth, and Madrid shares potential investors have been knocking on his doors.
There are more than a handful of investors who have been actively considering the Philippines. In the past months alone, the whole year actually, the office, has been busy entertaining and responding to investor interest, which has resulted in our being quite bullish about our near and medium-term prospects. So there is absolutely no shortage of interest in providing and offshoring work to the Philippines. However, you know, competition has gotten also more fierce because of this pent-up demand for offshoring, nearshoring work.
The Philippine Central Bank recently raised its growth forecast for BPO receipts this year to 9%, up slightly from an earlier forecast of 8%. It expects BPO income, alongside remittances from overseas Filipinos and travel receipts, to help stabilize the peso toward the end of 2022. The BSP expects travel receipts to grow 250% this year as COVID restrictions ease. Warren De Guzman, ABS-CBN News.